Hey, what's up guys, this is Amrusan and you are watching Trick I Know YouTube channel. In this video, I will show you how to get started with Raspberry Pi 4. Basically, in this video, I am explaining what the Raspberry Pi is and what cool projects you can do with it and which accessories you need to get started. So without wasting any time guys, let's get into the video. Before I start, I want to thank Seed Studio to sponsor this video. They sent me a Raspberry Pi 4 unit to make this video possible. If you don't know, let me introduce. Seed Studio is an online store on which you can buy single board computers and their accessories. Check out the video description for more info. So guys, now it's time to open this box. So guys, here is our Raspberry Pi 4 4GB unit with a Raspberry Pi 5V 3A US-based adapter. Here is a micro HDMI to HDMI cable and a tiny adapter to convert normal HDMI to micro HDMI. So basically, I ordered these items from Seed Studio by the coupon code provided by them. This is my order page. You can see the clear price of each unit here. Moreover, I have already a USB Type-C cable, some Class 10 microSD cards, a card reader to install operating system on Raspberry Pi, a regular computer monitor, and a USB keyboard and mouse for interface. So all these things you need to set up Raspberry Pi. Check out the video description for the item links. Now guys, jump over to the hardware specifications. Our Raspberry Pi 4 comes with 1.5 GHz Broadcom Cortex A72 processor with 4GB LPDDR4 RAM and with the OpenGL ES3.0 graphics processor which supports 4K at the rate of 60Hz. Wi-Fi is also inbuilt in this board at the rate of 5 GHz and also we have Bluetooth 5.0 facility. In the right side, we have 4 USB ports including 2 USB 3.0 ports and 1 Ethernet port. While in the bottom side, we have a USB Type-C port for power, 2 micro HDMI ports for dual display and 1 audio jack. In the top of the Pi, we have 44 GPIO pins to do some awesome projects. We have 1 micro SD card slot in the back of the Pi to install operating system on it. And we have 2 expansion slots to add additional items on Pi like camera. So these are the hardware specifications of our new Raspberry Pi 4. Now guys, I'm going to show you how to set it up. Single board computers like Raspberry Pi runs on operating system installed on the micro SD card. So here is my Class 10 micro SD card. Now I'm going to install operating system on it. All you have to do, just plug the micro SD card to your micro SD card reader, then plug it into any PC or a laptop nearby you. Here is my micro SD card. It's a brand new micro SD card, so it don't have any files. Now first thing you have to do, open up the browser and download these 3 softwares and install it on your PC. Check the link in the video description. Then next, search Raspberry Pi on your browser and then go to raspberrypi.org. It's an official Raspberry Pi website. Here you can learn all about Raspberry Pi. Now here you have to go to the download section and here you can see there is an official Raspberry Pi operating system called Raspbian and it's free to download. There are also many third-party operating systems for Raspberry Pi, but as a beginner, you can use the Raspbian operating system. Just click to download it. Here you can see there are 3 versions of Raspbian operating system. I will recommend to download the Raspbian Buster with desktop and recommended softwares. Just download the zip file to your desktop. Here I have downloaded my file. Now next thing you have to do, you have to format your micro SD card. So just open the micro SD card formatter. And here you can see I have already inserted my micro SD card and it's already mentioned here. Now next, click on format. then click on OK. Now right click on the Raspbian zip file and go to 7-zip and click extract here. It will extract the image file on the current folder. So here is my Raspbian image. Now next thing you have to do, just open the Etcher software, then drag the image file to the software like this. And here you can see our image is selected, our micro SD card is selected. Now next you have to click on the flash. So it will take few minutes to load operating system on the micro SD card, depending on your PC speed. So here my flashing is completed. Now you can close this software and eject your memory card. Now insert the micro SD card to the micro SD port of Raspberry Pi. Now the operating system is installed and it's ready to use. Now guys, it's time to set up our Pi. All you have to do, just plug the micro HDMI cable from the monitor, plug the USB type C cable from the power adapter, and also plug your USB keyboard and mouse adapter. So guys, our setup is ready. Now I'm going to power it up. In the first boot, it will take more time as a normal boot does. After that, the boot time will increase. So here our Raspberry Pi PC is started. And here is the welcome screen. Click next, select your keyboard, select your language, and you are good to go. Just like a normal desktop computer, you can set your own login password. I don't want to set it now. Now one thing you will notice, your screen resolution is not fitting on the screen. So in the welcome screen, don't forget to check this box. Just tick this option. The screen shows a black border around the desktop. Now hit the next button and finish this setup. After the finish, it will restart itself. And in the next start, the screen resolution will fit to the monitor. Now here you can see the black borders are gone and we are good to go. So guys, first I want to show you the real boot time of the Raspberry Pi 4. Here we go. So guys, it took 12 seconds to boot up. Here our desktop is ready to use. Now guys, there are lots of things you can do on Raspbian operating system. Let me show you the quick overview. As a normal desktop computer, you can customize your desktop. In the desktop preferences, you can go and change the desktop wallpaper as you want. Here are some default wallpapers. Here we have a start menu to access the programs. There are many programs are pre-installed in this operating system, so you can do your basic works. We have Chromium web browser. It's a Raspberry Pi version, Google Chrome. You can search, you can browse, you can read websites on this web browser. See how fast this web browser is working. You can watch your favorite videos on YouTube. Let me play a video for you guys. See how smooth the video is running without any issues. Now next we have a terminal. From this terminal you can download and install many softwares from the Linux database. Now here we have a file manager to keep files. Here you can put your documents. You can watch your downloaded stuffs and many more. Here we have a VLC media player to play media files on it. And this is LibreOffice. It's an alternative of Microsoft Office. Here you can make your projects, presentation, etc. And you can save it as a Microsoft Word. We have also some programming applications like BlueJay, Python, Scratch, etc. which can help you to make your dream projects. For entertainment purpose, here we have a Minecraft. It's a Pi edition Minecraft. So you can play it in your free times. So all these things you can do on the pre-installed apps of Raspbian operating system. but you can do more with the third-party operating systems. You can install Kali Linux for hacking, OSMC or Kodi to stream or watch full HD videos on your Raspberry Pi. You can make your Raspberry Pi a game console by installing RetroPie on it. You can play thousands of old retro games from the old times. You can make your Pi a portable PC. You can control thousands of sensors. You can make your own smart mirror, your own drone, and your own robot. You can also take care of your plants, and you can make your home automation. Raspberry Pi 4 have dual display port, so you can use dual monitor also. You can make it pocket PC, or even you can do this. So guys, that was my video on Raspberry Pi 4. Hope you enjoyed it. If you really enjoyed, give this video a thumbs up. And if you think this video is helpful, please share this video with your friends and families. You can buy all the Raspberry Pi 4 accessories from the link given in the video description. Check it out. And if you have any questions regarding Raspberry Pi 4, leave a comment below and subscribe my channel with the bell icon for more videos updates like this. Thanks a lot for watching guys. See you in my next video.